Okay, welcome everyone to the May 18th meeting of the Hadley Select Board. First item of business is the consent agenda. And on the consent agenda this evening, we have the minutes from May 11th. We also have warrants for payroll 45, 46, 47, and then accounts payable 65, 60, 62, and 47. We also have a decision on the clarifier bids, the land proposals, and the election warrant June 16th for the debt exclusion.
I just assumed the last three weren't on the consent agenda, and we'll want to talk about the minutes and the warrants, fine. But I'd like to take the clarifier, the land, and the election warrant off that so that we can talk about those.
Yeah.
That's my motion.
Second. Second? Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
With that being said, I'd like to motion that we accept the minutes and the warrants.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay, all opposed? All right, do we want to talk about those now or hold them until after the public comment period, David?
Well, whatever the pleasure of the board is.
That's part of the public comment, that's probably good.
Yeah.
Marlo's here for the clarifier.
Right, the clarifier. So David, you want to comment on that?
Okay, so the clarifier, we went out to bid, we did receive bids that exceeded the budget. The lowest bid, I think, was something like $60,000 above the available funds. Obviously, we're going to have to rethink this project and send it out for rebid. So because we've exceeded the funds on this project, my recommendation is that we inform the contractors that we're not going to be making an award at this time to anybody.
Any idea why we were so off?
My best guess is that the engineers gave us a low estimate. We've had some history with this happening before. That's my best guesstimate. Do you have anything to add to that?
Some of it was bumped because of the aluminum stainless steel items, apparently. It wasn't real descriptive from the email I got, but that was part of the increase.
Approximately how much were we off?
About $60,000.
Yeah, about 60.
So our course of action would be go back to the fall town meeting. This project is being funded by the sewer impact fees. We've set aside $207,000 from sewer impact fees for this project. We have about $258,000 in that account right now. So we know we have an additional $40,000, $50,000 that we can apply to this in the next go around. And we'll be adding to that that pot as we go through the summer months with new development. So that's my recommendation.
Okay, there's one Mr. Iskevich mentioned to me one time something about the painting. You could do a longer painting for not much more money, and it would last a number of years instead of the way we're doing it now.
Yeah.
I think Marlo, the
painting's only got a 5-year warranty, Marlo, correct?
Mm-hmm.
According to the contract. The seal coating really is good forever. It's good for 50, 60 years. And there's another concern that just come up in the past couple of weeks, which I don't, did Dennis send you the pictures of the bridge movement?
Yes.
So now we got another issue with the bridges, and the bridges weren't supposed to be removed, and I said they should have been removed right from the beginning, and now it looks like they're going to have to be removed and reset at some point. So, you know, there's other issues that have arose along with it being a little bit higher bids. I mean, I think this is probably going to grow a little bit more even.
Yeah, I'd like to comment on going back out to bid in the fall, late fall. The sub-bidders have been contacted, and with being later in the fall to have to do the painting, they're going to have to protect it from the weather, keep it above 50 degrees, so that's going to bump the sub-bid painting $8,000 right there. So that's laid off the press.
What I said was if we're going to go through all the trouble and sandblasting and cleaning this concrete, instead of putting a 5-year warranty paint job on it, to spend the money and make the investment, even if we have to go back to town meeting, to put the right seal coating on these tanks. You know, they're not deteriorated to the point where they need to be hydraulic cemented, and we've been through all of this with the engineers, and the engineers have their reasoning why, and, you know, and I just, I'm looking at the best interest of the town here right now. And the way we're short-term in everything, we're just short-term in this project. 5-year warranty on a paint job is nothing when we're going through $200,000 worth of sandblasting and replacement, you know?
So is that something you want to spend more time looking into and come back with a recommendation?
Yeah, I can look into that. I'd like a firmer price on what John's talking about as far as the paint, but I'd like to just reiterate when I heard back from the engineering firm, there's a possibility if we put a 30-40 year coating on that, that the system altogether may be totally different down the road. So 8-10 years from now, they may require a different system. So that's the other thing I would like to talk to the engineers further about. So yes, I'd like to do some more follow-up. I don't know, a lot of the limb here, yes, so.
Yeah, you know, nothing about the process or what we've been doing so far, but as you can see with our municipal buildings and everything else in this town, we're short-term and everything. And just, we're not saving any money doing that. I know it's expensive to get the work done the first time to begin with, but if you don't make it last for 50, 60, 80 years, or whatever it may be, we're gonna be paying for it again and twice as much in 8 or 10 years to put another coat of paint on it.
I guess the other thing I'd like to look at too is if we have to increase the plant, I'd like to look at those projections
yeah.
too, because if we invest the money in it and turn around and have to increase the plant size, then
yeah.
We'll get short-ended on the other end of it as far as our dollar too.
Exactly, and I had mentioned before you got here the possibility of our station 2, which is most of our flow, redirecting it to Amherst possibly. You know, there's a lot of options instead of just building a plant bigger.
So at this point, David's recommending that we reject the bids and
yeah.
rebid the project, and it sounds like we've got some time to see if there's any need to change the bid specs.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so does anybody want to make a motion?
So moved.
Second.
Okay, any further discussion on this at this time? Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All opposed? Okay. Then the second is the land. David, so these are the proposals for land that were not funded at town meeting?
That's right. So we have no funding for these purchases. As you know, we went out to bid. We received two proposals back, one for $425,000, the other one for $1.4 million and change. Town meeting did not provide funding for this, so we should inform the prospective sellers that we will not be proceeding on this, and we have an agenda item on this on tonight's agenda to discuss the next steps here. But as a formality, we should say thanks, but no thanks.
Okay. So moved.
Second.
Okay. Any further discussion on that? Again, it's on the agenda a little bit later on, anyway. Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
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 Any opposed? Okay. And then the election warrant for the debt exclusion, David.
Last meeting, you set a date of June 16th for the debt exclusion votes on two ballot questions. One is for the backhoe, and the other one is for the additional funding for the public safety roof. And so those questions have been prepared, and they're now ready for you to sign the warrant so that election warrant can be posted to alert people that there's a vote coming up. Two questions. One is for the backhoe. The estimated tax impact is $11.40 for every average single-family household for 5 years. Polling hours are noon to 8, and the polling place is Hopkins Academy. And for the public safety complex roof, the estimated impact is for the roof is $4.18 for an average single-family household for a 5-year borrowing.
Any questions or comments here from the board? Okay, John.
The trading value of the old one, is that going to offset the cost of this new backhoe?
I'm sorry, the trading value of
the trading value, what you get for that old backhoe, or do you intend to keep it?
Marlo, have you?
Yes, I'm in contact through the municipal bid Schmidt Equipment, and they've given a tentative number on that between now and then.
What is it?
It's somewhere in the vicinity of up to $20,000.
Is that money going to offset the cost of the, or is that going to go into some fund?
How have we handled that in the past?
The way we could structure it two different ways. We can either sell it separately, in which case the money would go to the general fund, or else we could do it as a trade-in and lower the amount of money that we have to borrow. In the past, what we've done is a trade-in.
Okay. Okay. Any opposition to that?
No.
Is that what you're going to do then, trade-in?
Yeah, I'm just checking, make sure the board's in alignment with that, right? So,
do you need a vote? To see what we're going to do.
I think at the time when we do make this decision, we obviously want to do the thing that is in the best interest of the Hadley taxpayers.
If they only offer $3,000 for the backhoe, yeah, I would say let's go to municipal bid with it. But other than that, if it's fair market value, I would certainly use it to offset the expense of the backhoe.
I would also add that I would like to trade also, looking at that very same thing, to lower the borrowing on that. And you know, not only that, between now and then, if something goes horribly wrong with it, you can make a different decision on that. But
okay, so moved. Do I have a second?
Second.
Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
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 Any opposed? Okay, all right, that's it for the items that were in the consent agenda. And then for public comment period, we'll open that. I just wanted to start that off by saying that it's always nice to get, we certainly all hear a lot of grief around here, but it's also nice when people take the time to applaud any of our municipal employees. So I'm not going to read the whole letter, but I did today in the mail receive a letter from Jim Freeman, and I'm assuming Margaret as well, from North Hadley, who wanted to thank the DPW for their prompt and efficient action in April. There was a situation at their house that could have been, there's a flooding situation, and they want to extend their appreciation for the efforts of their fellow Hadley workers, specifically grateful for the friendly diligence of Marla Warner, Mike Klamoski, Dennis Pipchinski, Billy Kelly, Jim Boursier, and Jason Hall and Ray Russell. So, very nice job, Marla. And I'm assuming you want to post this down at your...
Absolutely.
Is there room for another one of those down there?
Yes. I put a bigger board up.
And along the same lines, again, sometimes people appreciate certain interactions, and our superintendent took the time to write a note to David Nixon, thanking him for coordinating a meeting and his communication skills and facilitation of the meeting. She said it was a pleasure working with you and greatly appreciated. So again, it's always nice to hear these things too, because
you don't get many.
We don't always get many of this.
I had a pleasure of being at the building committee's meeting last night at their liaison, and I bring back four questions that we'd like that they would like answers to. So if I could bring it up. Concerned about the bid for the roof, can we please get the bid out before the money is approved? Certainly not to award it before the money has been approved, but can we please get the bid out as soon as possible? I think it's very concerned about getting that done in this building's season, so we don't come back looking for another $2,000 or $3,000 next year. So if we could, you know, if we could put that forward. They'd also like the RFP for a 3-acre site in North Hadley to be redone or to be sent out, but with a 3-acre. And I see that's going to be later on for this evening, but I'd like to bring it up then. And the RFP for the center of town, they'd like that resent out as well, since we've seen that there's been some additional interest in that. And again, I see it's on the agenda for later this evening. And to report back that on Tuesday, the 31st of May, there's going to be a summit meeting specifically to work on the design for a plan for the buildings for the town. And they're looking at having a rough draft available in the month of June at some point in time, which is going to be a more cohesive recommendation from the, as opposed to a piecemeal plan. So, anything else, Mr. Denwinkle, that I left out, sir?
No, we are putting together a recommendation report. It's a three-page unit, and we'll be giving it to the
selectmen discussed that last night, and should have it all set for, by the end of the week. And it's a recommendation of what we've done, what we're going to do, and what we're recommending for the next project, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6. And the selectmen will be getting a complete report, and this will go on, should go on for the next 2 years, and so keep you up to date on what's going on.
David, is it possible to get a quick answer? I know the land-related ones we're going to talk about later in the agenda, but the bid for the roof?
Certainly, as part of, you can go out to bid, just making it explicitly clear that the award of the bid will be contingent upon the approval of funding, and put in the date of the debt exclusion as well. So that's not a problem. If it's the pleasure of the board, I'll send that bid out the door.
Does anybody have an issue?
I'll make a motion to have them send out a bid with the contingency of the override vote.
Second?
Second.
I just have one question. What is summit meeting exist to? Does that mean they're inviting all of the departments that are concerned with building issues? What do you mean by that?
I think that they're going to be sitting down to, that they saw on town meeting floor that there should be some priorities brought forward as to how this is going to go forward. So they're notifying everybody via us that we're trying, they're trying to go forward with bringing about something that's a little more cohesive with everything. They're certainly, their meetings are open and to anybody, so.
Thank you for that clarification.
Okay, so we have a motion made and seconded for the roof. So all in favor of David getting that bid out?
Yeah.
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Okay, John?
What's the 3 acres of land for?
We haven't gotten there yet.
We're going to be talking about that later.
In North Hadley?
Yeah.
Possibly for a station up there.
And we're going to be talking about your subcommittee as well, okay. Okay, so are you all set with the?
I am. That was the 4 issues that I had to bring forward.
Okay.
From last night.
So this is a public comment period. Anybody? Mr. Allen?
Yes, the last time I was here, we talked about the budget shortfall or the difference between income and expense. And as I left, we had come up with $140,000 shortfall for town meeting, plus $251,000 for OPEB. Deferred to the fall, $15,000 for COLA for employees deferred to the fall, and school budget cuts about $75,000 deferred to the fall.
Request reduction for the schools, is that what you just said?
Yeah. And then additional services for consideration of all having to do with the police, worth about $49,000. Right, that added up to $530,000 shortfall. And I'm assuming that there was no material change as a result of the town meeting. Is that correct?
Since town meeting time?
Yeah. Correct.
Correct.
Okay. When I got home, I realized that there were two important things that we hadn't discussed. One is the money that we have been taking for years from meals tax and transferring it to capital stabilization. That was a ballpark of $250,000. Should that be added in there too?
We haven't got it yet.
Pardon?
We didn't receive one yet.
No. I'm talking about for budget purposes.
As a shortfall?
Yeah.
As a shortfall?
Yeah. Well, I think what John's talking about is during the course of the year, we collect meals tax. In the past, we've earmarked that to fund the capital stabilization account.
Right.
Is that what you're talking about?
Yes.
Right, which can't occur until after
I forgot to bring it up when I was here. So
right.
I'm bringing it up now.
Yeah, so I would say the answer to that is yes.
Add it to right. The short one.
Yeah.
Okay, and then one more.
Sure.
We entered this town meeting with $1.97, call it $2 worth of free cash. That's pretty low for a $14, $15 million operation. What amount of free cash does the town want to budget to have available for the start of next year's town meeting?
We made it on $1.87.
Yeah, I wouldn't try it again.
Yeah, part of the strategic planning process is, and as you all know, there are financial benchmarks and policies that the Select Board has adopted, and then some of them that have not been fully vetted yet. One of the things we've talked about in the past is whether or not there should be, I mean, best practices is like, I think it's like 3 to 5% range of free cash.
There are several, but go ahead.
But yeah, right. We're clearly, since we're sitting here in a deficit position, not in a position yet to say that this is what we're going into next year. Ideally, we would meet all best practices for finances, but this is going to be part of the strategic planning process to figure out how we're going to get back to that point where we're generating that free cash and not using it the way that we are now.
Okay, but I know, and you know from management, that unless you set a goal, probably isn't going to be made.
That's why we have a strategic planning process, so okay. We haven't gotten to those financial benchmarks yet, John.
Okay, so for the time being, the shortfall is $780,000. It's the 530 plus 250.
If that's the way you want to look at it, yes, as we sit here today, because free cash doesn't exist at the end of this year.
Well, how else is there
right?
To look at?
Yep.
Okay, we'll talk about revenues in the future.
Mm-hmm.
But and so you want to defer the free cash discussion until when?
We're trying to get agreement on a strategic planning process so we can start figuring out first and foremost how we're going to bridge the $140,000. In the course of that planning process, we're going to also then be talking about financial goals that need to be achieved, but it's not in the immediate this year issue, looking out 3 to 5 years.
Okay.
So I can't give you a date right now.
Okay, 3 to 5% of the operating budget, is that what you were talking about?
I said that's my understanding of best practices.
Okay.
Okay, but again, it's public comment, so we don't want to have too much dialogue on this. So question asked, and then I've got it down. So I know that you're expecting to have
right.
hear more
and,
about this.
And part yeah. of your rules is that you'll get back to us. So
exactly.
I'm just trying to establish when. I'm no hurry.
Probably, yeah, it's not going to be in the no. next 2 months, okay. I promise.
But it's something I
Madam Chair, can I make a comment on that? After analyzing the Finance Committee's projection after town meeting and their recommendations, it's quite obvious we're going to end up with another $2 in free cash because they're going to take everything out of it to offset the operating budget. And if we don't have enough money from free cash to cover our operating budget, the next thing from the chairman of the Finance Committee's mouth was, we will take the remainder from stabilization.
Okay.
So this is what we're looking at.
Options available.
Depending on revenues that are coming in, it could change. But what we have forecasted in front of us now, that's what it looks like.
Right, and just a reminder that that's an option, but it's not the decision of the Finance Committee to remove anything from
well,
free cash.
Well, you have to go to the voters.
Exactly, yeah. I mean, from stabilization.
This has been going on for 4 years now, really.
Oh, okay, that's why we're doing strategic planning.
There's
public comment now, so just if it's something unique, please say it.
Yeah, the past Finance Committee had come up with all these deficits originally. The present Finance Committee has come up with all these deficits. How many committees are we going to go through that tell us we're in debt before we need to make a decision?
Which is, and one thing I would actually, maybe we can put it on the meeting agenda for any board member who has the knowledge now that would allow them to make a suggestion on how to bridge that gap. I would love to hear it.
How about a meeting with the Finance Committee in the near future?
We have scheduled tri-board meetings, John. Okay, we're done. You're all set. John?
Next. I'm next.
Yep, you're next.
I'd like to know why another committee would set the priorities of this town and not the Select Board. No building committee should set the priorities. They should recommend to the Board of Selectmen. And the Board of Selectmen I've been after for quite a while now for infrastructure, and I don't hear nothing on it. I think the infrastructure should be pretty well up to top before you have a major, major problem. And I certainly would appreciate that this Board of Selectmen would set the priorities loud and clear for this town. Not no building committee, not any. They recommend.
And I perhaps if you heard that differently, I do believe that that's exactly what's going on. Yeah, there's a recommendation coming from the Municipal Building Committee.
So
they're not deciding.
So the board is intending to set that
We said last meeting.
Priority?
The buck stops here, yes.
Wonderful.
Yep, and then ultimately, it's the decision of the town. Anything else for public comment? Is this unique?
Yes, it is. It's very unique. Because Mr. Nixon wasn't the only one that received the thank you note. It was also the electrical and the building department received a note just like that.
Good.
So that's unique.
That is unique.
And it's a superintendent of schools. You've got to say that when you
that's
say
correct.
It's a superintendent.
Oh, no, I did say that. Yeah. No, I just, again, I think it's nice when people
that is really, that's the first time in my life I ever heard the electrical.
Okay, we're coming to the end of public comment.
Did I hear you say that at the next tri-board meeting there would be a discussion of the town's finances and the amount of free cash?
We haven't set the agenda for that meeting, but I have to assume that it's going to be a key consideration for an agenda item, yes. Okay. All right, so going to close public comment period. We did have a presentation scheduled for 7:15 from Public Safety. Our two chiefs have asked to defer that to a later meeting, I believe June 1st, due to some scheduling conflicts. So David, if it's okay with you, since we have some guests here tonight, would it be all right if we moved your administrator's report a little bit later?
That's fine.
Okay. Then tonight, if we could recognize the individuals here representing Happy Valley Compassionate Care and their
Compassion Center.
Compassion what?
A Happy Valley Compassion Center.
Center. Oh, it says care in here. Okay. Sorry about that.
That's okay.
Happy Valley Compassionate Center is here with their attorney, Mr. Albano. So, David, you want to just give a quick backdrop on this?
Sure. So, we've been contacted by Happy Valley Compassionate Center Incorporated. They're proposing to set up a registered medical marijuana dispensary on Route 9. They've been in touch with the planning board, and they have a meeting in June with the planning board. They've been in touch with the Board of Health, who's promulgated regulations restricting the sale of medical marijuana in the town. So they have worked with the Board of Health in order to begin the preliminary process of receiving permits for their operation. They've come to the select board in order to receive the state-required letter of support or non-opposition, and the select board took that as an opportunity to negotiate a host community agreement, which is allowed by law. We've had four meetings. We've had a number of productive conversations on this matter. We've done our homework. We've looked at model host community agreements from the towns of Mashpee, Southborough, Plymouth, Burlington. We looked briefly at Worcester and decided that was not an appropriate model. We've negotiated over a period of four meetings a host community agreement, which is in front of you. The host community agreement provides the following. Cash payment of $50,000 per year to the town of Hadley. Initial payment of $10,000 to a charity of the select board's choice, and $5,000 annual payments to that charity for a period of 5 years. They've agreed that their property is going to be subject to real estate taxes through the town. And they've also agreed that should there be a provision that's approved by the voters for the adult use of marijuana on the November ballot, that we would reopen this host community agreement and have a renegotiation of the terms of that agreement. They've signed their side, and so it's now available in front of the select board for you to sign.
Can just one comment. So David, myself, and our two chiefs participated in the process. So another thing I think it's important for the other board members to know is that the chiefs are in agreement with this. Chief Mason in particular did raise some concerns about the kind of the fear of the unknown future events, if there are any law changes coming, specifically the legalization of marijuana in this state. And so he was very active in promoting the agreement that we would have the opportunity to come back to the table And again, Happy Valley has agreed to that as well, recognizing that that could be a very, a potentially different set of circumstances. So I just want to make sure you knew that the chiefs are on board with this.
And this is still all just contingent upon a state approval of your permit, right? Correct?
Correct, yes. It's essentially a five-phase process. We're currently in phase three, which is the phase. To get through phase three, we're required to get a letter of support or non-opposition.
Is that why there's an August 1 start date on this? Is because it's going to take that long to get through the permitting process?
Yes, that's our best guess.
No, the August 1 date is the promulgation of the Board of Health regulations.
That's the Board of Health. That was last year. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. And what's the verbiage in here about tobacco for? Why is that in here? In the first paragraph. It looked like it was.
These are model state regulations.
Are you looking at the host agreement or something else?
So where are you?
I'm just looking at the Board of Health agreement. Yeah, the Board of Health regulations.
Yeah, so these Board of Health regulations are model developed by the Pioneer Valley Planning Commission.
Okay.
And they were adopted by the Hadley Board of Health over the summer, last summer.
Okay.
So two things tonight, correct, David? One is we're looking for a select board recommendation on the host agreement itself. And then the other is the folks from Happy Valley came before us looking for either a letter of support or non-opposition. So would there be two items here?
Yes. So I have the letters for the non-opposition or support, and I have the host community agreement.
Okay. Mr. Michikowski?
Yeah. At our last planning board or the one before, we talked to Lord Pioneer Valley Planning Commissioner member Larry Smith, because that's that proposal lies within the perimeter of the MOS, that he said that we cannot give them a permit to operate from that spot. So I don't know what you guys are going to do, but I believe the planning board will not approve that. So do what you
do. Not part of your jurisdiction. All you have to do is sign the letter of opposition or support or non-opposition and the host community agreement. The zoning issues is up to the planning board.
What is he talking about? If it's not allowed, what are you signing what? Tell me.
So this is a process that's highly regulated by the Department of Public Health.
I know it's highly regulated, but in that regulation, if it's so many feet away from it, the mosque is there for education of children, you can't put it there.
But that's not for them to decide.
Right. That's up to the purview of the planning board for you guys to discuss, look at the laws and interpret.
Well, we were advised with Pioneer Valley Planning Commission, I'm telling you right now.
Sure, but I mean, that's secondhand information too, John, so we really can't take
what
that.
What do you mean secondhand? We got it right from his mouth.
No.
It's not the town's business. They're just looking for a non-opposition.
Yeah.
Let the process continue.
Yeah. But
what's the harm to the town?
That's right.
That's right. So
what's the harm?
At this point, I'm just looking for a motion on the letter first, correct?
Right. So if we could specify whether you are in support or if you have non-opposition, that would be helpful.
Okay. And your recommendation?
What is the difference either way?
In terms of its practical impact, they need the letter regardless of whether it says we support this or we're not opposed. I guess it's what you feel is appropriate.
Yeah. One's more emphatic than the other? Is that a fair way to put it?
One is.
Yeah. Actually, the Department of Public Health specifically says they do not weigh one more heavily than the other. They just require we get one of them.
Yeah.
Okay.
Did you not make a motion to?
Are we still in the discussion phase?
Yeah, there's no motion been made.
I'll make a motion to accept both of those.
One
of you have to pick one or the other.
Support or
non-opposition.
Support both of them. Non-opposition, yes.
It's okay, either. So you're landing on.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, you're. To let them go ahead to the next step in the process is what I'm trying to say.
Okay, and you're recommending
so support.
Yes.
I'll second that.
Okay, so seconded for discussion. Did you have something?
Yeah, my question is the site itself. what's going to transpire with all the gas tanks that are in the ground there and things of that nature? Is the site going to be completely cleaned before you even attempt to do anything?
That's a planning board issue.
No, I'm just asking them if they have answers. I would just like to
The answer is yes. Those tanks are going to be removed. They've got a lot of money going into that site. You will never recognize it as what it looks like today. The tanks are going to be gone. A lot of money is going to be going into the building. Okay. It's going to be a medical facility.
Okay, so we have a motion made and seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
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 All opposed?
Aye.
Okay, so 3-2.
I wanted to know if you did any history or any research on how many prescriptions are being done in this area.
So the Department of Public Health actually tracks that information, but they do not disclose publicly where the cardholders are. So instead of a prescription, you have to become a cardholder. So the cardholder is essentially the prescription. They do not tell, they don't release the information publicly as to where the cardholders are concentrated or not concentrated.
But you must have done some research on this to know, with all of the others that are being proposed within a 4-mile radius of your facility, what impact that will have on your facility?
It's a totally fair question. One assumption that we have made is that not every applicant will actually end up opening. Several people have stated tonight it's a very stringent process. Not everyone will get through the process. We don't even know if we'll get all the way through the process. So while folks have expressed interest in locations that are nearby, we're not sure anyone, including us, will get through the entire process. The other piece is we've just looked at properties that meet local zoning, but also properties that we can get under our control. As you might imagine, those are extremely limited. It's very hard to find a property that meets all the qualifications, and quite frankly, I think this is the only one we thought we could find after a fairly extensive search. And so while we would prefer not to have them down the street from us, we're not sure they ever will be there, and this is the only property we could find that worked and worked inside of our business model.
Madam Chair, I'd like to explain why I voted no to these gentlemen, and I think they deserve that. My main concern was when you initially came in and the state changed everything over. Initially, there was supposed to be 36 medical marijuanas apparently in the state. Now it's become market driven. We could have 10 of them along Route 9. If somebody gets the feasibility study, I want to do it, and they're going to come to us. The market driven really scares me now, and that's why I voted no.
All right, so the next item under the same category would be acceptance or rejection of the community impact agreement. So it's the recommendation of the ad hoc negotiating team that the select board accept these provisions. So is any discussion on this, motions, questions?
I mean, until the process moves further down the line, it's, it really doesn't matter whether we agree to this at this time or not.
Well, this is securing our interest so that to the extent that there's a favorable outcome achieved by Happy Valley, this is securing the what is now a verbal agreement from them to pay property taxes, to pay $50,000 charitable donation, etc. So that's the reason to do it now.
Like I said originally, you know, my thing is the people that really need it shouldn't be charged more for us having our hand out and collecting extra fees from these gentlemen, you know, where the people that really need it could be getting their medicine a little bit cheaper, and a lot of end-of-life issues that some of these people do have, you know.
Just a reminder that the reason it's called a host community agreement and an impact agreement is there's concern on the part of our own public safety that depending on traffic, depending on behavior, clientele, security, clientele, all of that, that it's possible that this would have put a strain on our existing staff. So really the primary focus of this agreement is making sure that there's no negative impact to the town. This is capitalism. I mean, they're going to charge whatever they need to charge and whatever the market will bear for the services. So, and given your projections, I don't think that this is a significant impact on what you're going to have to price at. Is that fair to say?
I actually wouldn't say it's insignificant by any means. As we've discussed, I think, to your point, there's a lot of concern about patients being able to afford. We've studied the markets in Colorado and Washington, which are Colorado's the oldest active market, and what you're seeing is that the price comes down over time, so the price to the patients actually decreases. So one of the things we've tried to factor into our business model is to make sure we understand price fluctuations, so we do think that over time, price for patients will come down, and you've seen that play out in other markets.
Yeah, so we obviously want to be compassionate to the people who need this medicine, and we certainly don't want to do things that are going to drive the prices up, but just as you said, all the indications are that the price will be coming down. So I make a recommendation for the sake of the community that we sign this host community agreement. We've looked at it for a long time. We've studied other communities. I know that there are a number of communities on the other side of the river that have given out permits for registered medical marijuana dispensaries and without host community agreements, and now they're regretting that step. So let's finish the deal tonight and get them off to the planning board and to the Board of Health so that they can continue moving their business forward.
I make a motion we endorse the Hadley host community agreement.
Is there a second? Joyce seconded? Okay. All in favor of executing the community impact agreement with Happy Valley, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. All opposed?
No.
I'm going yes.
So three yeses are?
No.
No? Okay, so three,
and
two.
The only reason I'm saying yes is because you negotiated in good faith with them.
Mm-hmm.
And if they're going to be able to put their facility here in Hadley, we might as well get something out of it for our infrastructure, police, and fire.
Jennifer, did you get the vote on that?
I did, thank you.
Yeah, I'm just, like I said, I'm just looking at the patient's point of view.
Totally respect your opinion.
Yeah. I mean, it's great financially for the taxpayers in the town of Hadley. That's the way I feel about it. A lot of people do it, so.
Understood.
And I guess my comment again is, I'm a little nervous if this medical marijuana gets saturated in this Pioneer Valley, how are you going to show a profit? I guess it's a business venture on your part and you're willing to gamble, that's well and fine, but I can't foresee somebody making money when you have market value and you could put one next door to you and then you've got to confront with customers, and I just can't see it becoming profitable with it becoming saturated.
Some people making a pretty good profit at it today that are not legal. No.
Donald, yeah, you're just going to give that to the
person.
Okay, yeah, sorry. Okay. All right, so I think you're all set.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, guys. I'm forward to working with y'all.
You as well. John?
What happened to that? Why'd you pass over that public safety presentation?
The scheduling conflict.
They had a scheduling conflict, so they asked to move it to the June 1st meeting.
Am I on agenda for this thing?
The committee?
Right.
Yes, we're going to be talking about that. When we talk about land, we're going to talk about that. Okay. David, your town administrator's report, and you want to hit the highlights?
I'll hit the highlights.
I won't
repeat all the things that haven't changed from last week. So Route 9 widening, we had a meeting yesterday early in the morning in order to do the coordination for the utilities. Representatives of MassDOT, Town of Hadley, ET&L Corporation, Berkshire Gas Company met, and Berkshire Gas Company is still working on their replacement of the main line and service connections along the project area. The project area, by the way, is beginning to look like a construction zone. So you're going to see more impact upon traffic, closure of the north side of the north sidewalk, more digging, more surveying, more equipment, more police on the road.
Waterline work will begin with preliminary testing. That was today. The final design will be based upon the test results. We'll have an update on that when we get to that part. Sidewalk work on the north side has commenced, and people should avoid using the north sidewalk as much as possible. There is appropriate signage out there directing people away from the construction area. The parade is still scheduled to go on as normal, but we should encourage people to avoid using the north sidewalk to view the parade and line up along the south side as much as possible. DOT has requested a litter...
Can you comment on that portion of your
sure.
report? Will you accept that as we go along?
Sure.
Okay, my problem, I have a real problem with the way the contract was signed for Russell School and the staging area. Initially, I was told by the town administrator we're going to receive $1,500 and we're still going to negotiate the staging area. Now we have $800 a month, and I find out the reason why we're under getting $800 is because it stays under the $10,000 figure for bid processing. So we stayed at $9,600, so we wouldn't have to go through the bid processing. I feel if we did go through the bid processing, we would have taken in at least $25,000, maybe $30,000. So we lost, because of not going out in a bid process, over $20,000 on that contract. And we inherited a big problem with the parking area. The Legion is presently, they have no place to park. They're gonna tear up their parking lot going across it both ways. Valley, the Vodka Place had an agreement with the Legion for their overflow. They have no place to go. So I guess we have to start talking about providing some parking, maybe at the Council on Aging, I don't know. But we owe them that. We're crossing over the Legion's property with all that equipment. We don't have an easement to do that. We're landlocked, aren't we, back there? We have an easement to go across there? I haven't been told that. I asked that question.
Yeah, we have at least a 30-foot easement on the right side going right up to the check.
No one negotiated anything for compensation to the Legion for them. They probably should have got some compensation for the discomfort they're being put into.
Probably,
you know, and I
put a sewer line across.
Furthermore, let me finish. I would like to know who negotiated this contract. I was told Mr. Berg negotiated it, and he's our building maintenance person. Not the Board of Selectmen negotiated it.
Does the Legion own the land?
Yes, they do.
Not all of it, no.
Not all. They only own the lower part.
And we do plow.
We own the land right all the way up to the back.
Yeah, but that has no relevance here, plowing.
Well, it's an offer that we give them through the year.
Can I just comment? I mean, there's a lot of information that's out on the table, and not all of it comports well with the facts. We actually did go out. Well, first of all, the bid threshold for a property is
$35,000, not $10,000.
We did actually go out to bid. That bid was recorded in the Central Register and published twice in the Daily Hampshire Gazette. Posted it in Town Hall. We only received one nibble, and that was from ETNL. Gary Berg and I, with keeping the chair informed, negotiated an agreement, and that agreement is signed by the select board. We're good to go.
Gary Berg met with the commander at the Legion, and they were all informed regarding it in advance.
So you're telling me the best deal we could get out of there was $800 a month for everything? If they had to relocate that staging area anywhere else in Hadley, they would probably be a mile away from where they are because there isn't any land available. That staging area is so valuable to these people, they would have paid dearly for it, believe me.
Well, so Donald, you're not asking for any action on this. You want to.
I just want some discussion how the contract was done. I've got most of it. Some of the facts that I was told were wrong, apparently, with the bidding process. There's clarification there.
Yep.
I appreciate that from Mr. Nixon. But the process that was taken, I'm not fond of it at all. We have a liaison there. Why wasn't he in on the negotiations?
I was.
You were?
I was. Knew all about it, all the way along.
Okay, then that makes me feel a little better.
Yes, sir.
And Don, do you really think if they do any damage outside that 30-foot easement that they're not going to take care of it and possibly pave half that parking lot for the Legion? You don't think that's worth anything?
It's worth something, John, but I understand it's only a gentleman's agreement. There is nothing in writing, John. We should have it in writing if they're going to repave all of that area.
Okay. I don't really think they're going to plow it up and leave it.
David, you want to continue with your report? Sounds like Donald said he's got the answers.
Okay. All right, so MassDOT requested a letter from the town, which I have prepared for you here, to allow for night work on the water lines when, wherever and whenever it makes sense to lessen traffic congestion. It's probably in our best interest. The letter that I've prepared for you allows Mr. Warner to direct water line work at night as he deems fit. They also talked about the work with the American Legion. We're trying to work with the contractor to make sure that the May 22nd Relay for Life parking is adequate. I would like the select board to grant permission for the American Legion for special events to utilize the parking lot behind the senior center for any overflow parking for any kind of special events. Public safety complex roof, we've gone out, we've gotten the green light to go out to bid on that. Again, we have a June 16th debt exclusion ballot vote coming up. Polling hours are noon to 8 p.m. and the polling place is Hopkins Academy. And you've signed the election warrant and there are two ballot questions. One is for the backhoe for $150,000 and the public safety complex roof for $55,000. Just going on, Commonwealth Compact, we were awarded two projects, one for the financial management team and the other one for a Safe Routes to School project. I talked to our representative at the Department of Revenue, and they're going to be implementing these projects on a first-come, first-served basis. And we're expecting Hadley to receive their technical assistance in the late summer 2016. Electricity aggregation, we've submitted our service agreement for council to review. Just got the okay from council this very morning. So I'll be scheduling this with the board to move this project along. Capital improvement plan update for the next 5 years has been sent out to all the departments with a return date of August 5th. Senate Ways and Means Committee has issued their state budget recommendations. The full Senate is expected to debate the budget and issue their final budget next week. It'll then go to conference committee and then go to the governor's desk sometime in July. We got a little bit of a boost out of the Senate. The main issue right now is watching those state assessments and making sure that they don't swing in a bad way. And then the implementation of the town meeting votes, public safety complex, backhoe, tiny house enforcement is proceeding. The house is scheduled to be removed tomorrow. Pilot that's been filed with the assessor's office. The financials are being worked on by the accountant. The library trustees have developed a questionnaire to help with their efforts to assess their next steps. That questionnaire is available at www.hadleyma.org under town news. Please fill it out. It'll help them discern which way they should go in the future. It'll only take you a couple of minutes.
David, can I just jump in there quickly?
Sure.
So they've received, I think, close to 200 responses so far on that survey. Still, though, the majority are people voting in support of, and really what they're looking to find out is more information about why people may not be in support of the library building project. Of the people who have responded, indicating that they were, not in favor of it so far, about 85% of them said that they want to know what the plan is for all of the Hadley buildings before they support any individual one. So that's the way it's trending right now, but again, it's useful information for them to have.
Allow your voice to be heard. www.hadleyma.org/news. Stormwater permit update, and Mr. Warner is going to be talking about that again tonight, but I checked in with the Pioneer Valley Planning Commission about the prospect of joining the coalition. There is a Connecticut River Stormwater Committee. They'd be pleased to have us. They did talk about an annual cost of $2,000, and I'd like to explore what that means before we commit to that. They will be having an exploratory meeting, no commitment required on our part, for next Monday at 10 a.m., and I'll be going to that. I guess you'll be coming with me, and we'll explore whether this is an opportunity we should bring back to the select board. And in terms of the $2,000, we don't know if this is wrapped into the fee we already pay them annually. Is this an in-kind contribution, or is it a cash contribution? So we'll get that information back to you.
You know, I know you two went to the meeting, and you've got a lot of information, but it hasn't been brought really to the whole board. So I don't know if you guys can get all that information to us, or we can get these people in here to explain to us what's going on, possibly, and have them on the agenda at one of our meetings.
Be happy to do that, and they did provide that offer to us, so we can bring them in and have them talk to us. I did provide a link to the EPA Stormwater MS4 website in your package tonight.
Jerry?
We talked about changing the voting from the high school over to the grammar school. Mm-hmm. I know that was brought up as Mr. Mish was able to, because the heating system is much better for the registrars and all that. Wouldn't this be a good time to initiate that?
We did talk a little bit about that in our coordination meeting having to do with the generators, and I think the idea right now is that we're going to keep it in Hopkins Academy. For the time being, we have space heaters, which can do the job.
Well, it's June 15th. I'm not worried about that.
June 15th, but we're talking about in the future.
Right.
So that's the current thinking.
The school use form states that for the elementary school, all programs must be over by 9 p.m. for the elementary school on their forms.
Right. But the school committee, I think, has the opportunity to make an exception on that.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So it wouldn't involve them. Mm-hmm.
Willie? I met with Ann Friday, mm-hmm. and we discussed the situation with the generators, and she now understands why that the generators will have to be, the generator at Hopkins will have to be an emergency generator, and I've notified the electrician who won the bid, and he agreed that it should be. So when the new generator goes in for Hopkins, it will be an emergency generator. Therefore, that whole school will be
able to be
turned on. So we'll be taking care of that.
Good.
That'll take care of that situation, so we won't have to worry about the grammar school. Mm-hmm. And also, like David said, we have heaters. We have a heater for each one of the tables. For voting now, so that if it's cold, we'll just put the little heater with the blower on under the table, and we'll be able to stay warm.
So you're all set.
My only problem with switching would be capacity. Hopkins has the ability to take about 600 people, where I think the elementary school would be less than 250.
This is the override vote, not the town meeting.
Right. Election?
Yeah, we're not talking about elections.
Oh, you're just
talking about elections.
I thought you were moving everything permanently you wanted.
No.
Okay, if it's just that, that's a different situation.
Did you get the letter of thanks before or after you had that conversation with her?
Before. What was the reason it wasn't moved to the elementary school?
Problem's been solved. The heating problem with the coolness for the registrars was addressed with Willie and the superintendent.
Moving a polling location takes a lot of paperwork with the state. If we could fix this with a couple of space heaters.
That makes sense.
Okay. So, David, you're all set. One more item?
One more item, which is the upcoming projects and events. So the Relay for Life this Sunday at the May 22nd at the American Legion. Memorial Day Parade May 29th. American Legion to West Street Common. The Asparagus Festival on June 4th at the West Street Common. Crafts Fair at June 11th at West Street Common. debt exclusion ballot vote June 16th, noon to 8 at Hopkins Academy, and our special town meeting October 27th.
Excellent. Okay, anything further for David, or anything you can take offline, please do.
I did have one question about the notifications of the ballot town meeting. Did we, are the locations down from what we used to have? It's Town Hall.
You mean where it's posted?
Post office.
Yeah, North Hadley Hall.
Post office.
And what are we going to do when North Hadley Hall, if North Hadley Hall gets sold?
Put it on a tree.
Which tree? Weld it to the backstop.
How about just making a suggestion that we could put it at the Sugar Shack, maybe? That would be simple. There's a lot of, that's a public place. It's open all the time. It's no different than a post office. That may work.
Well, maybe we should ask, that's Jessica's purview, right, to determine the, so we could bring it up to her.
Yeah, right. So if we do sell North Hadley Village Hall, then we will have to find another place to post.
The church is there.
Yeah, it's just something to think about.
Sure. Jennifer, you want to put that down as a main? Thank you.
Can I ask a question?
On David's report?
Yep.
Yep.
Are these put online and under the administrator's report on the town website?
They're under the minutes of the meetings as a hyperlink. So when the minutes go out there, you can link right to his report.
What I'm thinking is that there's information in these reports, particularly if you look at 52 of them, that would benefit that dozens of volunteers for the town. And if there was some repository for these things, they could refer back to them easily without bothering anyone in Town Hall.
Well, no, I'm just saying, when Jennifer posts the minutes, when you go on and you find the minutes for a meeting, you'll also find the administrator's report.
I heard what you said.
Yep.
But what I'm saying
You're saying you'd like it somewhere else.
Well, there's a section on the town website for the town administrator. Mm-hmm. And I would think that that's where people would look for it, the report from the town administrator.
Okay. But yeah, we'll take it under advisement.
And I know that other towns do that. And okay. It becomes a historical record.
We're unique, John. You know that by now.
Pardon me?
We're unique.
All right.
Not like all other towns. You know that by now.
Right,
okay, come on. Play
next. Okay, so next agenda item is the stormwater permit.
Marlo.
Okay. I haven't dug into it too much since we last met last week. I've been running with Route 9 things, as you'll hear on the next item. But basically, I may repeat some of the information. It's a 31-page document. It's very specific how you move through that 31 pages. Everything is kind of in phases. The permit becomes in effect July 1 of 2017. September 27th of 2017, we have to have a letter of intent in. And what the letter of intent does is it's basically explaining how we're gonna manage the permit over the 10-year cycle. So in other words, how are we gonna meet the EPA requirements within the permit? So virtually, we're applying for the permit approval when you send this permit in, and it has to be in your hands before that date. And that's about as far as I've gotten with it until we go to this meeting on Monday and decide how we're gonna get we're going to get involved with the coalition or not. As soon as things calm down on Route 9 and get going, I want to dig into the permit itself a little deeper and see exactly what we need to move it forward. We have a little time, but as we all know, July 1, 2017 will be on the doorstep if we blink. So
more to come?
Yes, yes.
All right, so we'll just keep this one front and center for a while.
I think the select board asked for this to be on the agenda, knowing that we wouldn't have a whole lot of new information because you were concerned about the unfunded mandate part of it.
That was the question I had, was to petition them, the EPA to fund it or the state to fund it. However, they're going to, until that point, how can you accept something? You don't even know what it's going to cost you.
Mm-hmm. Right, we had talked last time about whether or not we wanted to take a position on it and go back to the legislative branch and express our concern. And I think John and I were both in favor of that approach. How does everybody else feel?
I agree.
You know, I don't know where DEP stands on it, but, you know, they're great at mandating, and then you're stuck with the bill after, no matter what it costs.
Is it?
It's like any mandate that we're confronted with, I feel we have to react to it. And that's what they're doing, and I think we're doing the right thing.
By going to the legislature?
Yes.
Okay. Joyce, you agree?
Yeah.
Okay, so do we need a motion on that, or can we just agree to?
Well, let's draft up something to our legislative delegation.
Or figure out if there's a coalition, certainly now that's whether it's through Hampshire County, Franklin County, the COGS, or however it is, everybody's in the same boat. Let's just, instead of, again, let's not go back to square one and redraft everything. If there's something currently out there, every other town's going through it. I'm sure there's some type of organized pushback that's being brought forward.
Maybe we could check with the Mass Municipal Association to see if they're spearheading something also.
Sure.
Can I ask one little question having to do with this?
You want to ask Marlo a question?
Yep, may I?
You may.
I did skim the 31 pages that I think is in the board docs. Mm-hmm. And I had two questions that came. One is, it seems to me that it focuses on Route 9 in the early stage. Is that, did I read that right?
Well, the map should be in, I haven't looked through the permit, but the map of exactly where Hadley's responsibility is. I looked at it briefly. It's just north of Route 9. And again, I apologize, I can't remember what roads it cuts off on. And then the southwest corner, looking at Route 9, southwest on a map. It's a good portion of the southwest part of town. So, yes, you're right, Route 9 does fall right smack in the middle of this permit, right in the center of Hadley. There was some discussion at the meeting to EPA that brought up these different issues, you know, unfunded mandate, so on and so forth. Basically, what was said was that's why the permit hasn't come out for 5 years, because everybody has sent their ideas in. And I must add, it was said to me that DEP actually was in defense of the Commonwealth to EPA on this and trying to get some of the stuff pulled off the permit. They pulled a few things off, but not significant, in my opinion.
And with respect to Mr. Laskevich's question, in that document is an Excel spreadsheet that allows you to calculate the cost of doing this. And as Marlo has pointed out, it's phased in over a period of time. So the annual cost any particular year, offset by what you'd be doing anyway, but just reporting to them, may or may not be very onerous. It's up to you to explain this to them. Or have them come in here. That was a great idea. Mm-hmm. Have them come in and explain it to them.
Okay. So is that your?
Yep.
You're all set? Okay.
All done.
You want to move on to the Route 9 widening?
Can I say one more comment on the LS4? There was a few questions that came up at that meeting, and in my opinion, I know it's an unfunded mandate, and you know we want to go back the other way with it, push back. I heard the word push back. But they were pretty clear in the meeting, this gentleman from EPA, because that kind of that question was asked in a roundabout way. And I have to approach this permit, or we should approach the permit as if it's not going to be put off, because it's already gone into register, it's happening. I would recommend that we at least move forward and see what we got to do to meet the first two deadline dates, for the simple reason is we don't want to miss the boat on that at the tune of $16,000 a day if that letter of intent isn't, and then that's what was said to us.
Mm-hmm.
So take it as you will. It wasn't in a threatening way or whatever, it was just described in an answer that way. So
if you can't fund your stormwater permit, we're going to fine you $200,000 a day. Okay. How are you going to fund that?
Sell your tone.
And again, I'm not being an alarmist. I'm repeating what was presented to us at the meeting a few weeks ago.
That's why we need to get to the legislature.
Do you have any more good news?
Yeah, Route 9 widening, Marlo? What good news do you
have?
Yeah,
good news. Spent a lot of time on it. as David had mentioned, we had a meeting yesterday morning. All utilities were there. For the water utility and gas company. Beginning of the meeting, gas company said that they were looking to possibly get started sometime next week, but probably June 1st. So at that point, ETNL, the contractor, the resident contractor, decided we can't wait any longer. So as you can see, stuff has started out here with widening of the north side. So their intent is to get ahead of the gas company. Now, rather than wait on the gas company to get ahead of them, they need to get the project going. They're under contract with MassDOT, so they're moving ahead. Three changes as far as the water, two of them, in my opinion, pretty minor. The third one I need to work on for a few more days. But one of the questions that came up was moving the service lines, water service lines, over to the 12-inch AC on the south side. The question came up, do we direct tap right into the actual pipe, or do we put a saddle around the pipe, tap, you know, drill a hole through it, and then put the corporation, what they call a corporation, into the saddle? I had brought that up early in the process when I got here on this project, because I've never had, nor have I asked anyone to tap a main, a AC main without a saddle. For the simple reason is if the tap fails, it doesn't thread right, you got to cut a section of main out, you got to shut the main down. And not only that, I would not want a corporation blowing off that main 6 months after the work's done out here, if it doesn't hold. So it's a very good, inexpensive backup for us as far as that main. It's going to come into the tune of somewhere around $3,000 for the actual saddles. There's an estimated 15 services that need to be converted over. In my opinion, very cheap money. So I sent the letter for that request change through MassDOT. It's not our project, so the caveat here is everything has got to go through MassDOT. It's kind of got to go up the ladder from me and then back down the ladder through ETNL, then back up through them, back to the town, to me, the town. So it's a little crazy with the paperwork. It's time consuming, but at the end of the day, we're doing getting a pretty good deal here on Route 9 for the work we're getting done. Fittings and flares came up. I don't want to bore you with all this mechanical stuff, but not many people are using flared corporations at the main anymore. They're using compression with a small gooseneck with the copper. We've done it for years in my previous community. People just don't flare water lines anymore. They've gone to the compression. They've got a lot better compression fittings. So I've allowed that change. ETNL actually came to me, but I had to request it up through MassDOT. That's the funny thing about the project. So. Number three, we did an excavation out here today. I had spoken about an alleged sleeve that was put in, and our water main was run through it back late 70s, early 80s. We dug the hole, we found the sleeve. The 24-inch cast iron sleeve is there on the north side, obviously. It's on this side, we didn't find it on this side. But the change, the reason we needed to know that sleeve was there is if we needed to run another pipe at a later date, without disturbing Route 9 if it failed.
How big's the sleeve?
Sleeve's 24-inch cast iron. And when we exposed the 12-inch transite main coming out, the transite main is actually in really good shape.
Sleeved.
So without putting a map in front of you, it's going to eliminate the original plan of running brand new 12-inch up the middle of this intersection out here, starting in front of the town hall, going into the north side of the intersection. Up 47, like 60 feet. When they trench to the center of this intersection, that is going to be pretty chaotic with traffic, with a shoring box and trying to trench through the middle and remove the 8-inch and put the 12-inch. So my proposed change is to tap off the 8-inch out here in front, come over and tap into the 12-inch that's by our front sidewalk that goes out through that sleeve. And on the opposite side, tap into the 12-inch and come back out into Route 9 and continue on as originally planned with the new 12-inch. I've been in discussion with ETNL. They don't think that it's going to be more money. They're actually saying that would be great for us. I have to take into consideration the traffic, the condition of the pipe. It would be pretty expensive at this point to replace the pipe that's in the sleeve out there. It's in good shape. I'm not really over concerned about that because of you have to remove the AC and you pay a pretty hefty price, 12-inch, 100 feet of it. So it was my recommendation that, well, exactly what I described. It gets all our utility out of the intersection off-road, so if we ever have a failure, we're not out in the middle of the intersection here repairing something. And that's about it. The one thing I want to add is MassDOT originally wanted me to get the engineering firm involved, Bayside. I called Bayside, and they're not going to be able to do anything until after Memorial Day. So in other words, this work can't be done until MassDOT has a mocked-up plan, a replacement page. Replacement page is going to run to $6,000. So now I have to say to myself, what's best for the town? Do we just run with a brand new ductile iron through the middle of the intersection and let ETNL, you know, deal with that? So I called MassDOT back, and I talked to Mr. McCabe, and I said, is there any way that I can mock a plan? I'll take an original plan, mock it up, do the parts list, add a few parts that weren't on the original tabulation sheet. Will the director accept it? So late this afternoon, about 3:30, he said, give it a whirl. So to me, if I have to mock up a plan the next couple of days and get everything I need and get it sent over and they accept it, then we save $6,000. If they don't accept it, then, you know, I have to decide, or we need to decide, is it worth the $6,000 to make the change at all? So that's where we're standing on Route 9. Okay.
Are you looking for a vote of support from the board this night, or just discussing it?
We're discussing it. I already sent the changes, the two minor changes, I would say, with the saddles and the corporations. I already sent them over at requesting a change. I didn't feel that it's not an emergency, but I didn't feel that we wanted to be ones to hold the project up either when ETNL wants to get working. So those were small changes. To me, the saddles are required, so it's just one of those things that I proceeded with. I think I had a blessing last week on some of this. This other change, I certainly, when I draw up the letter, I'd like to send it to the board. I want a better idea from ETNL what it's going to cost, if not less, which is a possibility that was said to me. Even wash, or even if it's a couple thousand more. It could be 20,000 more if we have a main break in the middle of the intersection, so 10 to 20 years from now. So that's where I'm at. I'm in the design process for the next couple of days. So.
Thank you. Anything else tomorrow?
No, I just had one question, and I didn't get to ask you before you left today, but you know, the sleeves there, it's great. We got 1976 or 78 pipe in the sleeve. How much to jack it right now? How much to jack it when it breaks? In comparison, again, just looking, not 5 or 8 years down the road, but
yeah,
you know, something that's gonna, again, it's not gonna last another 40 or 50 years. The ductile will. And if you jack 100 feet of pipe through, you're good for right. Another 100 years.
If that pipe today, John, had shown any way it was deteriorating or a problem, I would make the call right now and say, let's jack a new pipe through there. But by looking at the plans, I think if I add an additional gate valve out front here, so if this ever fails out here under the highway or whatever, we can isolate it on both sides and nobody's without water.
Yeah.
I know I'm not going around your question of the price, but I'm just trying to explain that if we drop a $600 valve in out here, we have time to push a new pipe. To remove the AC and to push a new pipe, you know, I'm guessing it's going to be a $7,000-$8,000 process, depending on what could happen under the highway pushing the pipe through the sleeve. So.
Okay. So if we're set, then so Legion's set, then we're good.
So the two letters that you just signed, one is to authorize night work for the water utility replacement, which will have a less impact upon traffic. And it'll also, for the restaurants along the project area, have a less impact upon them. So you signed that authorizing Mr. Warner to direct night work for the water lines. And the other one is to allow the American Legion to utilize parking on town property for special events.
Yeah. And I was okay with the night work. We're not in the middle of a residential area. We're out here.
Right.
I felt comfortable with that. And not only that, the other way around, if you had to shut mains down during the day, school's still in session if they get to that work. And then, of course, like you said, the businesses.
Sure.
And I'm going to try and time it out with them so that Mr. Donan isn't affected too bad either, because I can get in there early. I'm not sure the hours, but time to make the donut type.
So. Give him a heads up.
Thanks,
yeah.
Marla.
Yeah. Do they use town police for that, or is there state police being used?
I thought I saw one of our guys
Sergeant Cook was out in the intersection earlier today.
Yeah, I thought I saw.
Yeah, Mitch was there yesterday, and another Hadley officer was there today.
So if I can get a solid price on that third change, it's more intricate, it could be more money, I could be missing something, but I need to sit down and design it, so to speak, so. If it's not gonna be a great increase in cost, I may just send the letters that I'm gonna submit along to the whole board. They can take a look at it and let me know.
Sure, yeah, just coordinate it through David.
Okay.
Yeah, that's fine.
Alright.
To help with the traffic mitigation, I see the officers, they're working the lights manually to help move traffic mitigation, and it seems to be working much better that way manually.
Yes, out here this morning when the traffic was real heavy, it really didn't work out too bad with a dump truck taking up the northbound lane out here. I mean, going out on a limb, it's not all gonna be that way, because the whole road's gonna get pulled apart, but today went pretty smooth out there.
College is not in session, so it's a different animal.
Alright, next agenda item is the purchase of land discussion. So there are actually gonna be multiple parts to this. David's asking us to review and discuss two proposed RFPs. Again, based on the way votes went at town meeting, one of them is for purchase of land in North Hadley and then Center Village. As Jerry mentioned earlier in the meeting, there were some questions from the Municipal Building Committee, and we also have a request to form an ad hoc committee to look specifically at what opportunities there might be for the town with the current site of the North Hadley Village Hall, the land adjacent to that. Night, Marla.
Night. Thank you.
Yep. So, David, you want to?
So, I was interested in going out to bid on the property in the north end of town, and there's interest in submitting bids for property in the Center Village District as well. So I put together the two RFPs. They're very similar in terms of their scope. The only real difference is the evaluation criteria, where one gives more weight to land that's close to the town hall, and the other one gives more weight to land that's close to North Hadley Village Hall. They're very similar to what we just went out for RFPs for land. I would obviously time this for the October 27th special town meeting and any follow-up debt exclusion, so there would be a long time on these proposals.
So that we would have everything fully vetted in advance of that meeting,
right,
not getting down to the wire like we just did.
Right.
Let's not make the same mistake again. If we're going to go forward, or at least understand what the viable options are available to us, let's get this out and get it back as soon as possible.
Right. So
you've got a library that's looking at whether or not to go forward, or if to choose a different piece of property, if there's something else that's that provides information regarding something else that's available to them, maybe a piece of property for the senior center, or if there's something in the north end of town that's been determined that could possibly fulfill the needs.
We've also been looking at Keith, properties that may be coming up for sale through non-procurement means, such as tax title, chapter 61A, that kind of stuff. So we're gonna be reporting to you the opportunities that come up by those mechanisms as well.
Okay. So, so a couple of things. So we can just talk about North Hadley for a second. Mr. Michkowski has requested that we form an ad hoc committee. There's been an awful lot of conversation about the possibility of utilizing land immediately adjacent to North Hadley Hall for a fire substation. So there are a plethora of questions that need to be answered associated with that to find out if it's even feasible because of its proximity to Lake Warner, easements, sight lines, turn ratios for the trucks, all of that. So
we're waiting for some green bomb information. Did we get any of that?
I'm trying to have a meeting with him on Friday.
Okay.
And I will get you tomorrow.
Right, because the two of you are going to have further conversation with the bidder. So And then the municipal building committee, obviously, is also asking that we go back out. If you remember the parcel that was presented for town meeting, was it $550,000? And that was based on a particular.
Almost like 10 acres.
Yeah, almost a 10-acre site.
Mm-hmm.
That, so, you know, again, they're saying that's, they're not really identifying a 10-acre need, but they're suggesting it would be prudent for the town to own, have town own land in North Hadley. So, you know, the substation located next to the North Hadley Village Hall may or may not work out. So I think this is just another opportunity to run kind of a bifurcated track. So keep the RFP process going, looking for other land, and form, I mean, it's my suggestion that we go ahead and form the ad hoc committee to fully vet that site to see if it's feasible or not. Suggestions for participation on the committee. Mr. Michkowski has been very actively engaged in the process, so he would like, certainly like to be a participant on it. Perhaps a member of the select board, somebody from the municipal building committee, somebody with building design experience, town resident, somebody from the historical commission, and somebody from North Hadley.
I have some names that, that people said that they would serve on this.
So I,
they, if you want, I'll get everything to follow up this in writing.
Well, I'm just going to say, I think, and David, correct me if I'm wrong, I think the way that the process would work is if we agree on the formation of the committee based on the representation that we're looking for.
Then we need letters of recommendation from whoever.
Well then if people then submit their name and say, I want to be on the committee, then we can say, yeah, that's yay or nay. Is that right?
Can I read the names off that I talked to people that would want to participate in this?
I think yes.
Would that be okay?
It's okay with me.
Okay. Be myself, of course, Howard Cosby, the attorney, engineer, and former finance committee member, a member from the historic commission, and they're not sure which one, but they definitely want one on there. Myron Chudzik, a former fire chief and experienced in construction with Carroll's Excavating for quite a few years. Frank Oquadro, building contractor that built big buildings, and former finance committee. And I talked to Dave Wojciechowicz, and tentatively he would like to be a liaison between this ad hoc and the building committee. And Mike Mason, chief of police department, for advisory. Mike Spanknebel, fire department advisory, and Don Pipp for representative of the select board. There is a lot of things that have been done, like the historic commission, the planning board, talked to the ZBA, there's quite a schedule to do this. It's fill for the site, and it's a possibility to look at contractors and now that are projects that are now in front of the planning board to set aside fill to fill that basin in. There'd be a sewer tie-in to the, and a water tie-in. There's the manholes right at the end of Metal Street, the deep line there, so that's going to be easy shot. A set of lock and lights on Route 47, northbound and southbound, and one on Metal Street to be activated by a fire truck in and out, so the fire truck can go drive whatever coming northbound or southbound, lock the lights in, turn back, go right in the middle of the road, back right into the station, and all traffic's locked. That takes care of.
I'm sorry, are these things that the committee's here going to consider?
Right, exactly.
Okay, but no offense, but do you need to tell us all of this tonight or just wait until the committee meets and then present?
Well, I'd just like to let you know what's going on right now as far as looking into this. And I hope you guys don't put on an article at town meeting, because to me that's just a big slap in the face that the people voted no for the land already. they voted no on the land for the library and for the senior center. And yet, you don't even give it a rest of coming back the next fall without even looking at the feasibility of this project. And I certainly would like to start now to get ready for town meeting, because if you guys postpone this, this will never get all the facts together and information. And yet, talking to people out there, I've been talking to people ever since the general election about this, and there's a lot of people in North Hadley pretty excited about it.
Sure. So and the only question I have is, so Donald obviously lives right there in North Hadley, but Joyce is also the liaison to the public safety. So do you want to be on this too? And have Donald be like the community rep?
My question is, are these two separate issues, the village hall and the land, which she's in charge of the village hall now, and this is a completely separate issue dealing with the land itself?
Right.
No, she's the liaison to that committee, and she's going to be doing the negotiation and everything, and that's well and fine, but I think this is a separate issue away from the original committee.
Yeah, no, I meant Joyce is the liaison to public safety, just like you are to the schools and the like. So just, and I'm just tossing that out. So that
it doesn't matter to me if Joyce would want to continue doing that, that's well and fine, but I would just attend as a concerned citizen in the neighborhood, like everyone will be.
Right.
Well, we thought you could be on the committee, or I'm assuming that's what you meant, be on the committee as the community member from North Hadley.
That would be fine, and you could be the select board representative.
Yeah, because there won't be a quorum.
That would be fine. I would accept that wholeheartedly.
You don't think there's no conflict? The last 2 years, all she's wanted to do is sell that whole property.
And well, we are selling it.
Now, all of a sudden, we're looking at a portion of that property for something else. You don't think
because there was
conflict?
there was another idea brought up. There's nothing wrong with that.
Listen, we can just remember,
why are we even getting in an argument about it?
So I was going to say, and just remember,
make a statement.
It's in the code of conduct, which I forgot. I've got something this week.
Forgot the cowbell. Yeah. No, you got it there.
But in the code of conduct, you know, one of the things that's very clear is that once a vote is taken, regardless of your personal opinion on a particular topic, you have to represent the will of the select board. So I have no concerns. Joyce?
I don't either, because she's fulfilling the wishes of town meeting. That's what town meeting voted to do, and she's been exercising that from day one. And I don't find a problem with that at all.
Okay. So does anybody want to make a motion to form the ad hoc committee?
I would like to make a motion to form an ad hoc committee to look at the feasibility on that North Hadley Hall.
Second?
The property.
Yes.
The property.
Correct.
Not the North Hadley Hall.
Right.
The land.
The land.
Yep.
The land and the proposal for a fire station. Right.
Okay, so a second?
I'll second that.
Okay. Any further discussion on the formation of a committee?
Yeah. What's wrong with appointing the people that are willing to step up to the plate?
They haven't said that they need to.
I can get that letter tomorrow to confirm it.
And please do. And I mean, again, is there any concern about it? Does anybody?
No, but I think other people ought to be offered the opportunity as well.
Right.
I think.
How many people are you going to put on it,
John? If nobody applies, then there'll be nobody.
How long
else
is this going to take?
1 week.
No, 2 weeks.
2 weeks.
Oh boy.
So our next meeting, we're not meeting now.
You guys are good at kicking the can down the road.
So, people, there's a motion made and seconded to form this committee. Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Okay, great.
I think you're wrong for going 2 weeks, really. You advertise it right now on that TV. If there's anybody interested, we got 5 people that would keep a streamlined committee and get job done.
There's nothing to prevent people from researching whatever they want.
We're not meeting next week after that.
Right, but we're not meeting until June 1st, and then that's when we would formally appoint the committee.
The longer you postpone it, that the longer it's going to take to put out. This is not an overnight job, and if it's not done properly, it's not going to work.
2 weeks, that's it.
I also think we have to be fair with the general public. If there's other people out there with a wealth of information that we could use for this. We should at least give them the opportunity to submit to this, and it's normal procedure. This board has done that all along.
That's fine.
So it seems fair.
If it goes any longer than that, I'm not even interested in it, because that's all it's going to do is put more strain on getting information for this fall town.
And that will be reflected in the minutes. Willie?
Let's move forward.
Mr. Green.
How much land is going to go with the...
3 acres, sir. Copy of the bid.
With the building?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Let's get back to the negotiations. Let's get back to the land thing here.
Yeah.
We're not, haven't had discussion on that yet.
Right, so we're about to start talking about the land.
I don't think you can negotiate that until this project is set out.
There's many different opportunities that may be available if somebody comes up with a piece of land in North Hadley that's right down the road.
Listen, Mr. Town meeting voted no already. What don't you understand about no?
Okay, enough. So can we go back?
You just can't take no, can you, Harry?
Okay, we're limiting discussion to the board at this point.
Yeah.
So going back to the topic at hand, so
would
we want to go out with an RFP for acreage in North Hadley?
Yes. And the center of town.
Yeah, I'm just doing one at a time.
Okay.
Okay, does we have a motion?
But we need to state a purpose on it. That was the biggest complaint I had from the people that I spoke with at the town meeting. There's no purpose.
In the RFP?
In the RFPs for this property. So once the building committee gets their recommendations to the board for the buildings and the properties, then we have something to go by, okay? These two buildings or this building will go on this size piece of property in the center town. This type of building, these two departments can go on this size building, buildings on property up in the north section of town, if it's feasible.
If the piece of
property. But without the recommendations from the building committee, and we obviously aren't making any decisions on any municipal buildings, how can we ask people to buy a piece of land when we don't even know what we're going to put on it?
We're not asking them yet.
I understand. Yeah. I understand.
We're just starting the process.
But if we have some direction that more information on these properties that we're looking for, it's easier for the taxpayer to decide what they want to do and where they want to put it.
I agree with you in a perfect world, but the reality is right now we don't know what land, if any, might be available. So I think part of what the Municipal Building Committee is trying to determine is, you know, what property might there be access to help inform them. You know, so again, it's a difficult, is the cart in front of the horse or not, and all that good stuff. But
Madam Chairman.
Excuse me. We're having a discussion. So, I mean, I understand your point, but I also understand where the Municipal Building Committee is coming from as well.
Yeah.
So, you're right. Before we go to town meeting,
this is a discussion that I had. I mean, we just look like a bunch of fools up there. Yeah, let's buy a piece of property, but we still don't know what we're going to do with it yet. Mm-hmm. You know, and then we've had this other idea come up for the piece of property that we're negotiating to sell right now. Mm-hmm. But that we still don't know if we're going to sell the whole thing or not. You know, I mean.
I guess my problem with the whole situation is I'm a firm believer we have to get our financial house in order.
First,
and without that building committee talking to some financial people and knowing how much money can we afford to borrow, how can they even suggest to go out and purchase all these properties? We may not even have the ability to borrow for these properties. And I believe that committee has to talk to Linda Sanderson, our treasurer, and her idea of formulating up a committee to get these answers for them. We're really premature on trying to go out and buy land. We don't even know if we can afford to buy it.
But you need a piece. I'm sorry.
No, okay.
You need a piece. You need a number as to what the property would be. At that point, we can go to Linda Sanderson and say, Linda, we have a piece of property. It's $800 million. No, we can't afford it. It's $150,000. Well, maybe we can. But we need to know, based on the needs that's been provided to us by the building committee, as to a piece of property that they're looking for and the size of the piece of property at 3 acres. So somebody submits a bid to us. If it's 2.5 acres and it's $180,000, then at least we have something to bring to Linda.
Again, but I think you're putting the cart before the horse again, because the building committee's supposed to come before us, and they want to set priorities. Where is this land on their priorities? Maybe their priority is doing the infrastructure. Maybe their priority is taking care of public safety first. And maybe this is way down the list.
Whose priority?
The building committee's priority.
Is the building committee not asking the Board of Selectmen to send out an RFP for 3 acres of land in North Hadley?
For what use?
Yeah, but they're also coming in to tell us what their priorities are. I will want to hear their priorities prior to hypothetically going out to purchase land. If that's not their priority item, excuse me, I think we've got to hear from this committee what their priorities are before we do anything.
Yeah, Donald, I agree with you in concept, but I think I disagree with you in process. Completely agree with the fact that we need a plan, we need to understand what the plan is, and then address the funding, right? So, I mean, first you need to know what it is you want or need, and then you figure out how to pay for it. And I would argue that the Municipal Building Committee, that is not their task. That's our responsibility to take their prioritization and bring it back and say, okay, now we need to figure out how to put this in front of town meeting. First of all, do we even agree with their prioritization? And then second, what do we want to have the town decide upon? And when we bring it to the town, we're then going to need to tell the town how we think it can be paid for. Is it an override? Mm-hmm. So I agree with you, but I don't think it's fair to put that on the Municipal Building Committee.
Well, I don't think we have to do it so quickly tonight. I think the committee's coming in, let them talk to us and tell us what they want to do. And then we can make this decision about the land.
What does it hurt to send the RFP out?
I think we may be wasting our time and wasting David's time again.
It hurts the people.
If everybody votes no, we've wasted all kinds of money and time.
They already voted though.
I think the last two RFPs have really opened our eyes to the value of some of this property, whether it be in North Hadley or right here in the center of town. And nobody expected to see $1.2 million for a landlocked piece of property.
It's not landlocked. It's its own business.
So, it absolutely doesn't hurt to see what's out there.
And
you can open up the realtor sales pamphlet in the online or in the paper all the time and see what properties are going for.
Mm-hmm.
And they're not growing any more land in Hadley, just asparagus. So.
So. Two questions. Do we send out the RFP? And David, I mean, you've effectively done the bulk of the work at this point, right? Is that fair?
Right. Yep.
Okay. For, again, any available land in North Hadley and then property in the center of town. So do we want to take a separate vote on those two?
Let's do both of them.
Or do both of them at the same time? Is anybody adverse?
Is there a motion?
Remember, the issue with the center of town is that we did get some responses, but then we found out that someone thought that they had put information in and it wasn't in the format requested. So we found out that there was more availability, plus the one bid that came in was pretty pricey. So.
I guess I'm left in the dark again. When did we tell Mr. Nixon to go ahead and prepare these RFPs as a board? Never. We never had that discussion, but they were prepared.
A
who
year
told
ago,
them to prepare them?
A year
no,
ago.
The two new ones.
That's
not a
new.
Year ago, the two new ones.
It's not new.
Yeah, both.
It is not new.
The North Hadley one was a modification, David, is that?
Yeah so if I remember correctly, the last week you all asked me to put on the agenda the discussion about land purchases. It was something that we wanted to revisit. Meeting that was a recommendation of the Municipal Building Committee. It's a direction that the board decided to go in several months back. I took it upon myself to draft up the RFPs because it would be unhelpful to you to talk about an RFP process without having the evaluation criteria in front of you, which are the guts of the procurement process here. So. There you are.
I guess what I'm trying to say, these were prepared before Mr. Devine brought that information to us tonight, which doesn't make any sense to me at all.
Right.
is it something unique that you have to add to this
discussion? I got something that you need to listen to.
Okay.
And Joyce, you remember this. The school lost 7 times. Mm-hmm. The town got divided there. And now you folks are doing the same thing over again. The people voted against the land that you want to purchase again. They voted no, a strong no. They voted against this land, a strong no. And what you said, Mr. Washkevich, the land is landlocked. That land is not landlocked because it's all under the business zone. There could be a medical center there that would probably be worth millions of dollars. So don't laugh at that. But I urge you, board, you don't understand what no means, and you're divided. You're going to get people ticked off again. How many times we have to vote? Don't let this go with this other plan. Try this. If they fail, then regroup. But you can't wait. You're coming right back from the spring meeting right into the fall meeting with the same thing.
In the spirit of giving people options, if they make sense. We don't know that the proposal is going to work or not.
You didn't try it. Get it to fall town meeting.
Well,
never mind. You're going to put this to buy the land on.
Okay.
I'm going to tell you what you're going to have. You're going to have everything fail.
There's a huge mental leap that's being made here. We're taking a vote to obtain information. I do think that the people in town.
He said you're going to put it on in fall town meeting.
That want us to do fact gathering. We're fact gathering. As we move forward with the strategic plan between now and fall town meeting, we will have much more information, and in all likelihood, some of these articles that we're talking about now won't.
The main fact, Ms. Chairman, is you got to vote no on everything. Why are you coming back? For another no vote, or to get people peed off?
Well, no, you have to look at the whole picture, John.
I'm looking what you guys are doing.
The library is bringing back a different plan. If they voted no on the senior center, we have to be prepared for something else in the center of town.
You've
got
to be prepared to set your priority. A library is not priority.
Well, just because you don't use the library doesn't mean that other people in town don't use the library.
Listen.
They have to have that opportunity, and we have to do a menu.
What about our public safety? What about our infrastructure?
You guys want to vote.
Does somebody want to make a motion?
We're still in discussion. I agree with Mr. Washkevich. When he brought up about 15 minutes ago, what is going on that land? Who's proposing what to go there? Makes a big difference to me. If it's a senior center, is it a library, is it park and rec, what's going there? We're just buying land hypothetically.
We're not buying anything.
I want to know what's going there before I even consider my vote.
Exactly. Donald, I've talked to some of the senior citizens.
But we're not buying
anything. We're not buying anything. We're getting information.
We're getting to know what the availability of land is in the center of town.
But he said you're taking it to town meeting in the fall.
We don't know that. We want the information
of
what's available.
That?
It's called a request.
He's going to get the same vote he got on his form.
David?
Okay, so if we're talking about a town meeting process, even hoping to be in the town meeting process, keep in mind that a request for proposals for land has a longer advertising requirement. You're talking at least a month, possibly 6 weeks for the advertising alone to occur.
What's it cost?
So we're talking about a process that's going to take you somewhere between 6, 8, maybe even 12 weeks for us to go through before we even have the information that's in front of us. So, if you want to get set up for the fall, you have to be thinking months in advance in order to.
And what cost is this going to be?
This is not going to obligate us to anything at this point in terms of what are we going to use it for. That is something that we would have to designate at the town meeting when we're acquiring the property. There would have to be a municipal purpose spelled out at that time.
Right.
I'm going to make a motion to put out the two RFPs at this time to see what the availability of land is in town.
Second. Okay, motion made and seconded. Any further discussion before we vote?
Are these for two specific sites? She just mentioned land anywhere.
No. In the center of town.
Center Village.
And
Center Village and North Hadley. So we're talking, in essence, the same two parcels were voted down at town meeting. Which places are we talking about? I would like clarification.
You've got to go out to bid to find out what you're looking for.
There are no places.
You have no places. That's why you go out for the RFP. Once they submit it to you, then you know the places.
That's a different situation.
To see what's available, not to purchase, to just to see what's available.
Who's told you no more than yourself?
No.
That's all we're doing.
Okay, I understand that now. You made some clarification. We can look at other parcels, the committee, not only what was that. If it opens up the whole field again, that changes everything.
That's what we're trying to do.
Okay, that changes everything.
You know, the other statement I made is, once we get a recommendation.
I know we weren't purchasing it, but I want to see what's out there, any other problems. Yeah, I didn't understand that. This could even include his presentation for North Hadley at the same time, which is great.
You know, until we.
You want to make it fail, don't you?
Until we get a recommendation from the building committee on what we're going to do with the buildings, then we can size one building or two buildings up to a piece of property, no matter where it is or what size it is, and say, okay, this may be in the best interest of the town for the next 75 years.
But we still need to know what's available.
Exactly. No, I understand what you're saying, Joyce. I'm agreeing with you, believe it or not.
All right, well, there's a motion on the table.
But, you know, before we make any decisions and put it on town meeting floor, we need the input from the building committee.
Absolutely.
And then we're going to say, these are the two pieces of property, or these are the two departments that we're going to put on this piece of property if we buy. And we're going to look like we know what we're talking about, not like a bunch of clowns like last time.
That's what we're trying to do.
That's what we're trying to do.
We can get that information on the buy property.
I understand that.
John, did you have something unique?
No.
Excellent answer. Okay, we have motion made and seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed?
No.
Okay. All right, so 4-1. Okay, and the last agenda item of the evening, committee appointments and annual appointments. David?
So this is the beginning of the annual appointment process. We always go with the public safety personnel first for insurance purposes. So we have a list of fire and police appointments for the coming year. I've talked to the municipal collective bargaining units, explained to them that we're not taking an employment action here, that this is for insurance, liability insurance purposes.
So moved. Make a motion to reappoint the fire and police departments as so stated.
Is there a second?
I'd like to do the fire and police separate.
Okay. I'll make a motion to accept the fire department's roster.
I'll second that, and we have recommendation of the chief.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Again, this is for insurance purposes only, to make sure that there's protection. Okay, all in favor?
Aye.
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 Any opposed?
Abstain.
Abstain. All right, yeah. Okay, police?
And I'll make a motion to accept the roster for the police department as stated and approved by Chief Mason.
I'll second.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 Any opposed? Excellent. Okay, I believe that concludes the regular business. We do not have executive session tonight, correct? So we move into any announcements before we adjourn?
I have some announcements.
Joyce?
Okay, so the select board would like to send condolences to Heidi Bai on the passing of her mother, Dorothy Ellsworth, May 9th. We're sorry for your loss. And we also like to send our condolences to the family of Kenneth Cook, who passed away recently, and also to the family of Charles Chuck E. Malik, also our condolences to them also. And we would also like to invite people to attend the Legion Memorial Day Parade May 29th, since we don't have a meeting next week. People that will be going to the cemeteries will meet at the Legion at 10:45 to go to all of the cemeteries as listed.
What time?
10:45.
Okay.
At the Legion.
At the Legion, yeah. And what color? Are you wearing red or blue this year?
Not sure.
I'll let
maybe
me know.
Red, white, blue. Shall I do it again? I would love my select board.
Go ahead.
You guys are here.
since I did get more votes than you, John, but anyway.
But Joyce, it's still not your select board.
Well, I'm senior. Where it is my, I consider it mine because in my heart. And then the parade will start at 2 o'clock at the Legion and go down Route 9 to West Street. So we would like all to participate, and there will be refreshments afterwards at the Legion. Many thanks to them for doing this, and John Karish, Tommy Stolarski, Kathy Zaturka, and Gene Baxter. Again, if you'd like to contact them, if you'd like to be in the parade, I'm sure they would more than welcome your presence.
Joyce, I guess you have my commitment because I'm driving you.
Oh, good.
You're a bus driver?
I'm your bus driver. Awesome. I'm going to be marching too. I'm a Legionnaire.
Yeah.
And
fabulous.
We secured 2 buses from Five Star, no charge.
Great.
My cousin Dennis is driving the youth groups.
Okay.
So it's going to work out.
Great. Thank you.
And can I say something about the Hadley Cleanup Day, please?
Yeah.
First of all, I'd like to thank all the participants, and we've got probably 90% done with the 2 days, and the town is looking good. I would like to, we probably spent total about $185 for all the food and the banner. The banner was like $140, which we're going to use year after year, and we got donations from Walmart, like $50 worth of power bars. Stop and Shop, a $25 gift certificate. Lowell's donated $129 worth of garbage bags, which have been returned to the highway, 350 of them. And the banner is down there. Donut Man gave donuts and coffee. Primo fed pizza and soda, these local places. And it just all worked out well. And I'd just like to thank them for their donations. And one other thing, the town looks really great, and I noticed looking at the town hall is kind of shabby coming to Memorial Day. I would wonder if we have any money in our budget to possibly power wash it before Memorial Day so it really looks spiffy for the parade and people coming in. I don't know if we do in our maintenance budget.
Yeah, we have to use a low pressure power wash in order to avoid scouring the paint, but I can look into that.
And traditionally the town hall is decorated by an employee of the town hall, and you'll be impressed.
I appreciate that. That's great. I love seeing that.
In past years.
Yeah.
And my last thing with the cleanup, I would like to ask the board possibly to think about a Go Green Hadley committee to bring issues of maybe plastic bags, styrofoam before the board, maybe annual cleanup days, maybe solar issues, you know, and I think it would be a real benefit to the town of Hadley to have such a committee, an ad hoc committee, and it wouldn't cost us anything.
Okay, well, may do the appointments, maybe we can talk more about the, we have to do the rest of the committee appointments in June.
Yep.
That'd be a good time to introduce that.
I'd appreciate that.
If people want to, yeah.
Thank you.
Sure, we got to get up.
Any other announcements before we adjourn? John?
Anybody that didn't
see
the
sign in there?
Yeah.
Yeah, everybody sees
it. Yeah, go ahead. That just came, right?
Yeah. Anybody interested in the water quality reports that didn't receive one, I believe they're available either at the water department or at the town hall here?
And they're also available online.
Online.
Okay.
All right. So, do we have a motion to adjourn?
What's going on with the Legion this weekend? David, what's the Legion doing this weekend? Relay for Life?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay. So, motion to adjourn?
Motion to adjourn.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All right. Good night, everybody. Thank you.